As you might have noticed, AI is changing everything right now, especially on the internet. But don't you worry, this opportunity is just getting started. So today I want to show you four ways how you can profit from this digital revolution that is happening right in front of us. But first, we need to talk about this overall trend, right? Because for many people, this came out of nowhere in December 2022. But by no means is this topic brand new. For enthusiasts and technology-minded people, AI has been around for years. It's just the killer app that came out with ChatGPT that woke a lot of people up. But enough estimates for now. Let me show you the cold hard data. If you look at the Google search trends here, you will find that the ChatGPT hype from early December kind of faded in the beginning of January. Look at that, it dipped over 50%. But this last uptick right here didn't just come out of nowhere. It happened due to a lot of mainstream people talking about it and some critical news coming out. Concretely, Joe Rogan talked about it on his podcast, and Microsoft revealed that in March they're going to be releasing Bing Search powered by ChatGPT. And the overarching news story here is that these things are not just a fad that come and go. Every groundbreaking news story can reignite the trend at any time. And the thing is, in 2023, so many of these apps will be coming out. And that's why we'll talk about some of these use cases here today on how you can capitalize on that. But just be wary of the fact that the AI segment is so much larger than just ChatGPT, all right? Especially the image generators caught a lot of fire in 2022. And what you need to be looking for with all the opportunities today is the next waves that will be coming. Because if you're gonna go ahead and take one of the opportunities we talk about here, which is creating video content, and you're gonna do it about the topic of using ChatGPT, well, it might do well, but frankly, compared to my channel, you're just not playing a fair game. And that's simply due to the fact that my first upload was on the 5th of December, right here, all right? So I started working on the video here and I finished it right here and I caught this entire wave. And that's what you need to be doing. You have to have your eyes wide open for the next killer app, because that's gonna make all of the opportunities that we talk about today so much more practical, because the supply just simply won't be there yet, because you'll be first. So keep that in mind. And also, I have to show you this graph that compares the NFT trends to the ChatGPT trend. And while some people criticize the current AI hype,
oh, it's just another crypto type hype.
No, you have to be aware of the difference here. AI tools delivered killer apps that are available today. NFTs had a lot of promises and communities built around it, and some artists use it for digital scarcity, but it didn't have that one killer app yet. Here it's a different story. You open up ChatGPT and it can essentially simulate every single profession on planet Earth like this. So while yes, there is a lot of hype right now, I wouldn't expect this to have the same trajectory, as 2023 will be full of releases that are going to blow our mind. And you know, I don't like long intros, but I have to say one more thing here, and that is I hesitated to make this video for a while, and there's a reason for it. I like to create my content around things that I thoroughly understand. And even though I'm no machine learning wizard and super coder here, I'm a practitioner and I've been using ChatGPT since the day of release more than probably 99% of people. And that's why I have the ability to present you these things. I didn't want to break in here and be like, hey, here's some ways to make money with ChatGPT without having made any. Now that the YouTube channel is doing well and people are loving the ebook, I feel like I have some experience that I can share with you here. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. And I want you to watch out for other people that simply talk about these opportunities without having gotten their feet wet. Because just like with NFTs, especially in January, this space attracted a lot of opportunistic people that simply want to make a quick buck. And I pride myself in this list being a little different. It's more grounded. So let's get into the first point here of how to make the most out of this incredible opportunity that is available to everyone digitally 24/7. And we're going to go down the list from hardest to execute to easiest to execute with no experience, all right? So the first one is building AI-powered tools that are niche specific. That is our first opportunity here. And the reason it's first on the list, because this one is the hardest to execute. Well, first of all, you at least need some coding basics. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to build an app or an API that you're going to be able to sell somehow. Well, at least not one that is worth anything a few weeks from here, because people will figure out the opportunity and pluck the low-hanging fruit first. So what to do? Let's say you have coding skills or you have a friend that has coding skills. What to go for? Well, my recommendation would be very niche specific. And that brings me to my first example here, which you probably heard of already, Lensa, right? The photo app that allows people to transform their normal photos into these AI portraits. And if you didn't know, Lensa is built upon the open source deep learning technology called Stable Diffusion. But they trained it in a very specific way. They trained it in a way to be good at transforming human faces. Then they created an app on top of that freely available technology and monetized it. Now, this is what I wouldn't recommend you do, because they were going for such a wide market that it's going to be very hard for an individual or a small team to scale up to that. And opportunities like this are going to be eaten away away, but the big participants in the market anyway very soon here. So I would rather go for a small niche and then expand from there. Okay, but let's be a little more concrete. What could you create here? Well, there's these two models that are currently open and you can use their APIs or the open source code to build upon. First of all, Stable Diffusion, just like Lens has built on that. With that, you can build art generators and train them to your desire. By the way, great example for that would be Levels.io on Twitter here. He built these two apps and made over $60,000 in a month with virtually zero cost. One of the apps creates these avatars and the second one specializes on using this technology on interiors. And now you can go down the list. You could train your models to be specific for a use case, put out a free version and some monetized tiers to it. But look, the problem with this approach is you're building upon other people's technology, right? So in the case of Stable Diffusion, it's open source, so it's available for everybody. So the competition is quite large. And it's the same for ChatGPT. The API is open for everybody, so everybody can build the easy apps that you just thought of, and they probably will. And that's why speed is your friend here. If you want to start and do this, do it today.
Do it!
And that's where a little bit of my experience comes in, because as you could see, I got my first video out before the hype wave took off, and I managed to get my ebook out even before Christmas. That meant at the beginning of January, the second version was done already. Now, how did I do this? Well, I didn't sleep much in that time, and I neglected pretty much every other part of my life. But that is what's necessary if you're a solopreneur or you have limited assets but massive ambition. Okay, so let's talk about the second opportunity here, which is content creation. And that includes all types of content, so let's talk about this, okay? So again, this thing is a pyramid, right? There's low-hanging fruit, just like blog posts, and that's why everybody's talking about,
yeah, use ChatGPT to generate blog posts and you can make a killing off of it.
Well, the fact is, one person that gets this right and has some Python scripts in place can knock out tens or maybe hundreds of these articles a day. And trust me, services like Google are not gonna be liking those. They're gonna have their own tech which is trained with ChatGPT that is gonna detect the one-to-one ChatGPT outputs. And then they're gonna rank those lower because it's gonna be more generic than a lot of the best human-created content. So that concretely I see as a very short-term strategy. Yes, it might be working right now and it might be worth a shot, but don't expect to create income from that that will last over the next years. But I think where this content opportunity starts getting a little more interesting is where you get into the harder tiers of it, right? If you're just doing an article that you're posting on Medium, it's literally one prompt, maybe say write that in the style of XYZ, and then you copy paste it into Medium, done. Now if we talk about something like a video, right? These things take a while to produce. I spend most of my Sunday researching this and none of this is scripted. And you'll also see that from the way I talk and repeat and cut and everything. This is just me free flowing of points that I've thought about thoroughly. And then also all this, the studio, the cameras, the audio mixing.
None of this is automated.
That's my soundboard that I had to set up. And then the editing and the distribution is a whole different story. So what point am I trying to make here? If you're creating an article, you're gonna spend maybe 5 minutes creating it with the use of ChatGPT. If you're creating a video, even if you use the video for the entire script, which as I said, I'm not. And I think if you get the choice, it's better not to. But then again, it's more work and you need more expertise. But even if you were to script the whole thing and use AI voices to communicate the message, you would still end up with a workload that is like 50 to 100 times more than simply putting out a blog post on Medium. And that's why less people are gonna be doing it. And if you go a tier further and you add production value like this, and you research more, and your thumbnails are better, well, all of a sudden there's not gonna be so much competition. So that's why I think the video opportunity here is exceptional, because ChatGPT can be a world-class assistant here. You'll still need to do a lot of the heavy lifting, but that's the price you pay for results that are gonna be more valuable and more relatable as time passes. So let me show you an example here. Here's an interesting channel on YouTube called AI Tripreneur. Now I'll just give you my unfiltered opinion here, and that is that he kind of took the middle ground. He didn't go like fully custom, high production value and all that, but first of all, he's still using his voice, and secondly, he's using this avatar instead of himself, instead of just stock footage. But the content is very niche and frankly really valuable and excellent. So even though he's not using his face, and I bet a lot, if not maybe even all of his text is scripted, it's valuable information that gets delivered effectively, and that's why the channel works. Now, could he put more work into the thumbnails? Yes, absolutely. I feel like that's something you should not skip if you're going down the YouTube route. But if you see him individually, they have a really distinct look, and I guess they work for him. It's just when you have this channel view that it all kind of blends into one. So again, just like with the first opportunities, he used his expertise to go into a certain niche, and he's showing exceptional speed of execution. Look at that. He's uploading every few days consistently. Perfect. And honestly, I have two more opportunities that I'll tell you here, but I feel like this is the biggest opportunity of the entire space, because there's just so much demand for quality video content across all niches. And with the help of ChatGPT, the workload is kind of manageable now. Because up until now, if you had to plan, write, present, be the producer, be the cameraman, be the audio technician, edit the video, design a compelling thumbnail, write a killer title, and then manually distribute it when you're starting out the channel,
they ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine.
Well, let's just say that's a lot of work for one person. But now in most of those, you can cut out like 20 to 40% of the workload with the help of ChatGPT. And as the channel and my newsletter move forward, this is a topic that I would like to cover more in depth, because this is the one where I have the most expertise. And frankly, video creation has been the only thing I've been doing over the course of the last 7 years. But I think you get the point now. You can't go for the quick wins, because they're just gonna fade immediately. You have to go for the opportunities that take some more work, except with our next opportunity here, which is affiliate marketing. Now, why would this be so interesting with this AI revolution? Well, I think all of us can agree that a seismic shift is happening in our society. And over the course of 2023, we're gonna see a lot of people get left behind. And those are gonna be the people that are pretending like this is not happening, or it's not important, or it doesn't concern them. Now, in between the camp of, okay, I don't care about this, whatever, leave me alone with this AI stuff, and then people like me that wake up and check all the industry specific news, there's gonna be a lot of middle ground. And that's where most people fall. They are interested, they are open to this, especially the younger crowd, but maybe their peers are not doing it. And in school, they're not teaching how to create amazing AI art with Midjourney, right? And what you could do is simply push some of these people over to the more informed side by bringing their attention to some valuable products. And by its very nature, it's a whole lot easier than the first two opportunities, because there you kind of had to create a product and then you had to market it too. Here, your job is to market and somebody else is creating that core of the value. Well, okay, but what could you market? What are these opportunities here? I'm seeing two things unfold, and these are happening as we speak, okay? So this is stuff that is gonna keep popping up over the course of the next few months as some of these projects and products get completed. So one would be technological products. And if you watch this video, you already know about the nature of those products. They're built upon these open APIs that nobody really owns and everybody else can easily compete on. So what is their biggest struggle? Their biggest struggle is getting a lot of customers fast. And if not most of these have affiliate program already, they will very soon, because they will have to. As long as you don't have something groundbreaking like OpenAI did, you're going to want to attract as many people as possible. And the best way to do that is to open up it to the customers to distribute it themselves. Just look at Amazon. They're notorious for their massive affiliate program that pretty much lives in every YouTuber's description. That's how big it is. So look out for these apps being released that have affiliate programs. And unfortunately, I don't have a good recommendation yet. There's some, but I can't recommend those in goodwill because I haven't tested them myself. Now, the second category is not apps, but products. And look, I'm just gonna take my ebook as an example because I really believe in it, and feel free to educate me, but I feel like it's the only product around ChatGPT that offers a worthy affiliate program. Right now, that is. Okay, so what's happening there and what's the opportunity? You can click the link in the description, sign up to the affiliate program, and start finding ways to promote that thing. And every time someone clicks the link and buys, you get $8. Now, I'm pointing out this opportunity because the book is still super new and I haven't had the time to expand into other social media channels except of YouTube yet. I also just know for a fact that the book is very valuable, which is a fact, because less than 0.004% of the people that bought it actually complained. And as there's no other similar products out there right now, you could just go ahead and create TikTok channels in various languages and start promoting this thing. Now, I reckon that over the course of the next few months, a lot more of these products are gonna keep popping up and there's gonna be more opportunities. But if you package it correctly right now, it seems like an easy sell to say, hey, there's this revolutionary app that is changing people's lives, and here's a product that gives you beginner-friendly cheat codes to use that technology. So yeah, keep your eyes open for opportunities like this. Just know this space is currently getting filled with scammers, and a lot of people are going to be spinning up products that they're never going to update again, never going to market again, never going to put their weight behind. And if you're an affiliate for those, it's just a very short-term opportunity, which can be fine. Just be aware that's what you're getting into. And now the last and probably most interesting opportunity for most people that listen to these videos. Chances are that most people don't code or have a limited amount of time. But what everybody watching this video obviously has is a mind that is open enough to absorb some of this new information and put these artificial intelligence models to work. Because that's what we love doing on this channel. We love using this tech. And if you're in that camp, you have a massive advantage against anybody who's simply not using it. So the last opportunity that I want to highlight here is any service-based business. Right. Any service-based business. Because every time you're in touch with customers and you're delivering some service to the customer, you can improve that experience with the use of ChatGPT. Okay, Gore, how? That's very vague. Well, I'll tell you how. Okay, so just because that's my background, let's say you're a video production company and you're gonna offer your services to customers. How do you power that with AI? Well, you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna dissect it into the different phases of the business. First up, you contact the client somehow, let's say by email. So that's number one. Secondly, you're gonna be in touch with them. Let's say you're in a phone call or you meet. So that's number two. Thirdly, once you agree, you're gonna be providing some kind of service. So there's going to be video preparation work. That's number three. Then the next phase is going to be the day of the shoot. Phase five. Phase six is post-production and phase seven is delivery. Now you take every single one of those and you think about how AI could help. I think we don't even need to talk about the first and the second phase, how this can help. It can prepare scripts to inspire your approach. You can generate ideas in different ways with creative prompts and asking it the right questions to get new approaches to approach the people. And then depending on their replies, you can consult ChatGPT to come back with the right answer to persuade them. And then once you have the job in pre-production, this is a godsend. I mean, Midjourney allows you to sketch a picture like this and get an output like this.
Whoa.
So now compared to somebody who's not using AI, you're just gonna kill it on the storyboarding and the ideas that you present to the client. And when you show up to produce the thing, you're just gonna be so much better prepared. If you're doing interviews, you're gonna have more questions than you did before. If you're doing narrative things, your storyboard is gonna be better than before. In editing, you can use some of these image generators to create a creative transition. And then here's the most important part. You deliver the final product with a list of ideas that they could do moving forward. Now look, if they ask you, just stand by it. Yes, I use AI, but I use it intelligently to help you out. People are not gonna have a problem with that. And then rinse and repeat. And that's a video production business, all right? If you're doing something like copywriting, the quality and amount of services you can provide just shot through the roof. If you sketch out 20 pictures like this, you can use Midjourney to storyboard or at the very least communicate your ideas to your clients. And you can start doing that today, right? You just have to know how to use these tools.
Do it!
And just from this video, I bet you gained more knowledge than most people that you meet on the street have by default. But hey, now it's up to you. You know about these opportunities. You have some of the tutorials on my channel. Take this AI advantage seriously and go and make some money. And if you want to learn more about some practical use cases, you can check out this video.